السلام عليكم. This is the second lecture of MRSUG version. Oh, it is the second part. Okay. Management of suspected ovarian mass in premenopausal women. Up to 10%. Women will have some form of surgery for the presence of ovarian mass. 10% of the suspected ovarian mass were found to be non-ovarian in origin. Up to 20% borderline ovarian tumor appear as simple cyst on ultrasound. The majority, 80% of such tumor on ultrasound will have suspicious ultrasound finding and feature. Clinical examination, poor sensitivity for detection of ovarian mass between 15 to 51%. Aspiration of ovarian cyst, either vaginal or laparoscopically, is less effective and associated with high rate of recurrence, it's about 53 to 84%. Management of bladder pain syndrome, this green top guideline. The incidence and prevalence rate of the bladder pain syndrome between 2.3 to 6.5%. Voiding was found to relieve the pain in 57 to 73% of the patient, and the pain is aggravated by stress about 61%, by sexual intercourse 50%, constrictive clothing 49%, and acidic beverages 54%, coffee 51%, spicy food 46%, and 12% has a past history of chlamydia. 12% of cases of bladder pain syndrome had a past history of chlamydia. Other guideline, management of genital herpes in pregnancy. The disease is located to skin or eyes or mouth. The infant who present with symptoms localized to the skin, eyes, or mouth alone have the best prognosis and represent approximately 30% of neonatal herpes infection. With appropriate antiviral treatment, neurological and or ocular morbidity is less than 2%. In case of local CNS disease and disseminated infection, 70% of infants with neonatal herpes have disseminated and or CNS infection, and approximately 60% of infants with local CNS and or disseminated disease will present without skin, eyes, and or mouth infection. Infant with local CNS disease of present late, generally between 10 days and 4 weeks of age. With antiviral treatment, mortality from local CNS disease is around 60%, and neurological morbidity, which may be lifelong, is 70%. Disseminated disease carries the worst prognosis with appropriate antiviral treatment. Mortality is around 30%, and 17% have long-term neurological sequelae. The incidence in the UK, around 50% of the reported from the other European countries. Approximately 50% of neonatal herpes is due to SHV1 and 50% due to HSV2, herpes simplex virus 1 and 2. Most cases of neonatal herpes occur as the result of direct contact with infected maternal secretion, although in 25% of cases A possible source of postnatal infection was identified, usually close relative to of the mother. Where primary episode genital herpes lesions are present at the time of delivery and the baby is delivered vaginally, the risk of neonatal herpes is estimated to be 41%. Women with recurrent genital herpes should be informed that the risk of neonatal herpes is low, even the lesions are present at the time of delivery, zero, range from the 0 to 3% for vaginal delivery. Up to 15% of cases where women present with the first episode of clinical herpes simplex virus infection, it will be actually be recurrent infection. Chickenpox pregnancy. Over 90% of individuals over 15 years of age in England and Wales are zero positive for Varicella zoster virus IgG antibodies. Primary Varicella zoster virus infection estimated to complicate 3 in every 1,000 pregnancies. In a study of British healthcare worker, 95% of those who reported previous chickenpox infection had antibodies. Adverse effects of Varicella zoster immunoglobulin include pain, erythema at the site of injection. The risk of anaphylaxis is such as less than 0.1%. The incidence of maternal chickenpox occurring before 20 weeks of gestation is about 0.91%. The risk appears to be lower in the first trimester, 0.55%. If maternal infection occurs 1 to 4 weeks before delivery, up to 50% of babies are infected and approximately 23% develop clinical varicella despite higher titers of passively acquired maternal antibodies. Parvovirus, 50% of women at childbearing age are immune to parvovirus 19 infection and therefore 50% are susceptible to infection during pregnancy. What is risk for hydrobis developing of infection occur at the 9 between 9 to 20 weeks or 13 to 20 weeks of gestation are 2.9% and 7.1% respectively. Parvovirus is responsible for 15 to 20% of cases. Medial cerebral artery Doppler for the prediction of fetal anemia is also reliable for the prediction of fetal anemia secondary to parvovirus infection, sensitivity between 94% to 100%, and specificity of 93% to 100%. Toxoplasmosis, about 14% of women of reproductive age are immune to toxoplasmosis and about 30% of 30 years old are in immune. About 1 every 500 women become infected during pregnancy. Primary infection in the first trimester, 70% of the fetus affected, 25% affected in the second trimester, and 65% in the third trimester. So the primary infection is common in third trimester. Overall, 60% of fetuses are born without obvious damage, 10% have chorionitis, retinitis, and only 20 to 30% have multiple anomalies typical of Torch syndrome. Spiramycin therapy to infected mothers, 60% reduction in the risk of fetal infection. Cytomegalovirus, primary infection occur in 2% of pregnant women, can be isolated from 1% of all neonate. Mortality from neonatal cytomegalovirus disease 20-30%, with 90% of survivors have long-term surveillance. 5-10 of infected neonates are symptomatic at birth. Of asymptomatic neonate, 5-15% develop symptoms by the second years of life, usually sensorineural deafness. The diagnosis and treatment of malaria in pregnancy, 75% caused by falciparum. And the average death of 5-15 deaths per year. Mortality 0.5-1 in UK. The parasitemia of severe malaria can be less than 2%. Pregnant women with parasitemia of 2% more parasitized RBC are high risk of developing severe malaria and should be treated with the severe malaria protocol. Uncomplicated malaria, fewer than 2% parasitic RBCs in women who no sign of severity and no complicated feature. Severity of malaria determines the treatment and predict the case fatality rate. In uncomplicated malaria, low case fatality 0.1%. In severe malaria, fatality rate are higher, 15-20% in falciparum malaria. The prevention of malaria in pregnancy in UK is about 79%. Vivax 12.9%, Avail 0.5%, malaria 0.21%. Umbilical cord prolapse incidence about 0.1-0.6%. In case of breech presentation, incidence high at 1%. Obstetric intervention can result in cord prolapse, approximately half of cases. Amniocentesis and chorionic villus sampling. It is estimated that around 50% of the pregnant population. The risk of miscarriage following amniocentesis around 1%. Continuous visualization of the needle with ultrasound reduced blood stain from 2.4-0.8%. Clear review with CVS sampling varies between 2.5-4.8% and spontaneous miscarriage rate of 3% after transabdominal CVS. The risk of severe sepsis is likely to be less than 1 per 1,000 breeches. Antenatal corticosteroids reduce neonatal morbidity and mortality. A single course of neonatal corticosteroids reduces the risk of neonatal death by 31 respiratory stress syndrome by 44% and intraventricular hemorrhage by 46%. Pregnancy and breast cancer to screen top guideline. A lifetime risk of 1 in 9 in UK. 15% of cases are diagnosed before the age of 45 years. 10 to 20 of cases may be associated with pregnancy or occur within 1 year postpartum. Fewer than 10% of women diagnosed with breast cancer have subsequently become pregnant. A recently reported series of pregnant women who were breast cancer survivors resulted in full-term births, 51%, spontaneous miscarriage, 8%, and induced termination, 41%. Christian Kefalik version and reducing the incidence of term presentation. The success rate of Christian Kefalik version is approximately 50%. Success level are for multivirus women 60% and for nullivirus women 40%. Spontaneous version from the bridge to Kefalik is unusual at term and occur only in 80% of primary gravid women after 36 of gestation. Spontaneous reversion to breech after successful Christian Kefalik version is rare, only 3%. The risk of emergency cesarean section within 24 hours is approximately 0.5%, with the indication in over 90% being vaginal bleeding or abnormal CTG following the procedure. The proportion of undetected breech presentation at term has been reported as high as 20 to 32.5% of all breech presentation. The possibility of breech presentation should be always considered at the clinical examination, although abdominal palpation has sensitivity only 70%. Management of breech incidence 3 to 4% at term. The risk of prenatal mortality is approximately 0.5 per 1,000 with cesarean section after 39 weeks and 2.2 per 1,000 with planned vaginal delivery pairs. Elective cesarean section was associated with two to five fold reduction in prenatal mortality when compared with vaginal breech delivery. Emergency cesarean section rate with planned vaginal pairs vary from to 29% to 45%. UK data reported that the breech presentation at term is not diagnosed until labor is about 25% of women. Female genital mutilation. UNICEF estimates that the world over 125 million women and girls have undergone female genital mutilation. The most common immediate complication from FGM were hemorrhage, 5 to 62%, urinary retention, 8 to 53%, and genital swelling, 2 to 27%. Blood scarring have been reported is up to 3% of women. Management of endometrial hyperplasia. The risk of endometrial hyperplasia without atypia progressing to endometrial cancer is less than 5% over 20 years. Just recall. Women with atypical hyperplasia, the risk of coexisting ovarian cancer was up to 4%. The risk of progressing to higher than stage 1 endometrial cancer was about 2%, and the risk of metastasis, disease, and death was about 0.5%. Management of monochorionic twins. Approximately 30% of twins pregnant in UK are monochorionic. Twin-to-twin transfusion associated with 15% of monochorionic twins. TAPS, 2% of uncomplicated monochorionic diamniotic, and up to 13% of monochorionic twins post laser ablation. Selective growth restriction. cross the cordon of more than 20%, approximately 10 to 15% of monochorionic twins. Fetal death occurs in 18.1% of fetuses. The management of ovarian hyperstimulation syndrome. In cycle of conventional in vitro fertilization, male ovarian hyperstimulation syndrome has been estimated to affect around one-third of cycle, while the combined incidence of moderate or severe ovarian hyperstimulation syndrome varies from 3.1 to 8%. The incidence of hospitalization due to ovarian hyperstimulation syndrome of 0.3%. The incidence of thrombosis has been estimated to lie between 0.7 and 10% of cases of ovarian hyperstimulation syndrome. Long-term sequence of polycystic ovarian syndrome. Syringe incidence range between 2.2 to 26%. Insulin resistant in present around 65 to 80% of women with PCO. Women with PCO have 2.8-fold increased risk of for endometrial cancer. In women with PCO, excessive weight reduction of a little as 5% of total body weight have been shown to reduce the insulin resistance and testosterone level, as well improving body composition and cardiovascular risk marker. Post hysterectomy vaginal vault prolapse has been reported to follow 11.6% of hysterectomy performed for prolapse and 1.8% for other benign disease. Management of perimenopausal syndrome, incidence between 5 to 8%. The investigation and treatment of couple with recurrent first trimester and second trimester miscarriage. Recurrent miscarriage affects 1% of couple trying to conceive. It has been estimated that 1 to 2% of second trimester pregnancy miscarry before 24 weeks of gestation. The age-related risk of miscarriage in the second trimester to be, this is recall, 12 to 19 years, 13%, 20 to 24 years, 11%, 25 to 29 years, 12%, 30 to 34 years, 15%, 35 to 39 years, 25%, 40 years to 44 years, 51%, and 14 above 45 years, 93%. The risk of further miscarriage increase after each successful pregnancy loss is reaching approximately 4% after 3 consecutive pregnant loss. Antiphospholipid syndrome are present in 15% of women with recurrent miscarriage. In approximately 2 to 5% of couple with recurrent miscarriage, one of partners carries blunted restructured chromosomal anomaly. The reported prevalence of uterine anomalies in recurrent miscarriage population range between 1.8 to 37.6%. The management of nausea and vomiting of pregnancy and hypermesis gravidarum, weight loss greater than 5% of body weight, بريمسس جرافيدارم افكت بتوين بوينتس 0.3 تو 3.6 فور بريجننت وومن ريبورتد هاي بريمسس جرافيدارم ريكرنس ريت فاري فروم 15.2 تو 81% liver function tests are abnormal in up to 40% of women with hyperemesis gravidarum. Thromboembolic disease in pregnancy and the preparium acute management. PE in pregnant woman with suspected PE is 2 to 6%. The risk of antenatal VTE is 4 to 5 fold higher than in pregnant women than in non-pregnant women of the same age. Venous thromboembolism can occur at any stage of pregnancy, but the preparium is the time of highest risk, with estimated or relative risk of approximately 20-fold. If DVT remain untreated, 15 to 24% of this patient will develop PE. PE during pregnancy may be fatal in almost 15% of cases, and in 66% of these, deaths will occur within 30 minutes of the embolic event. ECG show abnormal in 41% of women with acute pulmonary embolism. The most common abnormalities were TV inversion, recall 21%. Antenatal and postnatal mental health. Depression and anxiety with around 12% of women experiencing depression and 13% experiencing anxiety at some point, and many women will experience both. Depression and anxiety also affect 15 to 20% of women within the first years after birth. Postpartum psychosis affect between 1 and 2 in 1000. Thank you.